In the previous movie, we showed how to create a particle swarm inside a turbulence field using a Python plugin. Recall that we had used the following robot as an analogy to represent a single command instance. In this movie, we will cover how to define custom flags to control the number of particles and the dimensions of the turbulence field. Open the swarm command part2.py file in any text editor. Continuing with our analogy, our robot's memory is initialized with two default values in the swarm command's init function. Default num particles, which determines the default number of particles the robot needs to create, and default dimensions, which determines the default turbulence field's size. Our goal is to give the user a bit more control to override these default values via flags. A quick distinction should be made between flags and arguments in the context of a Maya command. Flags are optional and appear as named parameters when the command is called. Arguments, on the other hand, are the command's mandatory nameless parameters. In Python, a command's arguments appear before its flags, whereas in MEL, the arguments are placed after the flags. In our case, the swarm command will not require any arguments, but will accept two optional flags to change its default behavior. To create a swarm with 30 particles, the user would call cmds.swarm with the np flag set to 30. Similarly, running cmds.swarm with the dim flag set to 585 would create a turbulence field of size 5 by 8 by 5. To achieve this, let's start by focusing our attention on the syntax creator function. Syntax creator returns a msyntax object. This msyntax object contains flags which have been added via its addFlag function. Syntax creator is registered along with the cmd creator function reference in the call to register command. This binds the syntax declared in syntax creator to the command instance returned by cmd creator. In the code, the numParticles flag has already been added, so let's add the dimensions flag. This new dimensions flag is intended to control the x, y, and z dimensions of the turbulence field in which the particles will fly around. First, add a call to syntax.addFlag. Set the first parameter to dim. This is the short name of the new flag. Set the second parameter to dimensions. This is its long name. Set the third, fourth, and fifth parameters to openmaya.msyntax.kdouble. This ensures that the new flag will expect three numeric values, one for each x, y, and z axis of the turbulence field. In comparison, the numParticles flag only expects one numeric value, denoted by a single openmaya.msyntax.kdouble. When you run the command specifying 20 particles and a 5 by 8 by 5 turbulence field, Maya packages all the flags into a single object and supplies it as an argument to the doIt function. Following our analogy, to unpackage or parse these flags and their associated values, the robot calls the helper function self.parseArgs. Notice that this call is surrounded by a try except statement to let the command end gracefully in case the user provides invalid arguments or flags. In parseArgs, the robot uses a margparser object to parse the arguments based on the command's syntax declared in syntax creator. The numParticles flag has already been set up to have its data parsed and stored. The robot first checks if the flag is set via argdata.isFlagSet. The argdata.isFlagSet function can check whether or not a flag has been set based on its short name or its long name. We've chosen to check based on its short name, np. The robot reads the flag's value as an integer using argdata.flagArgumentInt. This value overwrites the robot's default value stored in self.numParticles. To parse the data of the dimensions flag, add a new if statement to check whether or not the flag is set. In argdata.isFlagSet, we'll use the flag's short name, dim. Assign the value obtained from argdata.flagArgumentDouble to the self.sizex instance variable. The zero index represents the first parameter associated to the dim flag. Assign the second and third parameters associated with the dim flag to the self.sizey and self.sizez instance variables. These parameters are indexed at 1 and 2 respectively. Now that the instance variables are set, they can be used in the doit function. The self.sizex, self.sizey, and self.sizez instance variables are used to scale the turbulence field. These instance variables are also used to delimit the region in which the particles are positioned. Self.numParticles is used in the for loop to determine the number of particles to append to the mPoint array referenced by self.particleposition. Save the file as swarm command part2.py in your Maya version's plugins directory. If you still have the swarm command part1.py plugin loaded in Maya, you'll have to unload it before using swarm command part2.py, since both plugins define the same command name. At this point, you should also make sure to delete any previously created particle systems and turbulence fields in the scene. To safely unload this command plugin, open the script editor and execute the flush undo command. This empties Maya's undo history, removing any command instances or robots whose actions could be undone. Now that the undo stack has been cleared, you can safely unload the swarm command part1.py plugin from the plugin manager and load the latest version, swarm command part2.py. To use the commands flags, open Maya's script editor and in the Python tab, execute the following line. You'll notice that the new particle swarm's turbulence field has different dimensions compared to the default one and also contains more particles. You should now have a good idea of how to add your own flags to a fully undoable and redoable Maya command plugin.